Today I'll be going over the Pendulum Swing animation exercise. If you stick with me to the end of the video, we'll be turning this into a ball and a chain swing. This is how mine turned out. Okay, to get started, go to File, New, and Animate. And we're set this up with HD settings, so 1920 by 1080. You can also type this in on the old versions of Flash if it doesn't have the preset. We're going to start by naming this layer Scene and extending the timeline to about 6 seconds or 140 frames. And then we're just draw a circle in the middle of the stage. Select the circle, hit F8, make sure this is a graphic symbol, and then name this C. So this is where we're going to have the main animation. So this is the animation layer. And then if we select all this, hit F8 again, and name the symbol Ball. And this is where we have the pendulum itself. So if we go in here, this is the layer called Ball. And the layer above this, I'm going to name Line, and draw a straight line coming right out from the ball. Then we can just put the line layer underneath the ball there by clicking and dragging it. If you hit Control A, it will select everything. Hold in Shift and drag this down so the tip of the line here matches up with the pivot point. Now double click anywhere in the stage to go outside of this and hold on shift and bring this back up so everything fits inside the white stage here. Okay, so we're going to make a reference layer. So each swing will take 21 frames. So frame 1 is your first key and 21 is your second key. Then we need to find out where the next key is. So we're just going to select these keyframes here. Hold down Alt and drag this over to make a copy. And that's how we find out that frame 41 is going to be the same as frame 1 where everything loops. Frame 11 is your breakdown, and that's where the pendulum is actually in this position. So at frame 1, we need to rotate the pendulum so it's at the highest point on the left-hand side. And then at frame 21, we need to do the same thing, but on the other side. So I just copied this frame by hitting Ctrl-C. I'm going to go to frame 21 just on the reference layer and paste it in place by Ctrl-Shift-V. And I have this set up as a key command, but if you don't, you can right-click and go to transform, flip horizontal. I have it set it up as number 1 on my keyboard. And we're just going to outline this. So now you can see where this, where we can match this up to. I forgot to make a keyframe first. So you need to hit F6 here to make a keyframe first. And then drag this over. And you can delete the reference. The reason why we can't just take frame 1, put it here, and then flip it would be that your tweens won't actually tween that. It'll just start going kind of crazy because Flash won't understand what happened. So that's why we could only use it as a reference and then match it up. Let's put a blank keyframe at frame 11, and we're going to find out where your next breakdown will be. It's going to be on frame 31. And it's exactly the same as frame 11, so we can select frame 11, hold down Alt, and drag that keyframe over into frame 31. And we're going to do the same thing for frame 1 and drag it into frame 41. So now this should go this way and then go back to screen left. So if you select all these keyframes, right click and create classic tween, it will play, but it's not looking quite nice yet because we haven't added any time. So we're gonna go over here to this first set of tweens, select any frame in that tween, and go to your properties panel. If you don't already have it open, you can go to Windows Properties or Control F3. And we're gonna select where it says Classic Ease. And we're gonna wanna put ease in either cubic or quart, depending on what you think looks good. Just make sure you keep this all consistent for which one you use. So we're gonna use the ease in here. And then ease out here. What that's doing is it'll make it go, all those drawings will be like closely spaced together and then get further apart as it goes down. And that will make it appear to be going slower and then faster. And then it's the opposite when you ease out. So it'll be going faster and then slower in this section. And if you turn on the onion skin, this is what it looks like. So since things are spaced further apart in the middle right here, it will appear to go faster in the middle and then slower in the ends. And then we just need to do this on this side too. So the same settings, ease in, and then ease out here, report. And then when you play it back, it looks like it has a little bit more of a natural timing. If we go back out here, we can just play this through. And it looks all right, but it's actually having more frames on the screen left side than it is on the screen right side. And that's because if you go in here, you see frame 1 here is the same as frame 41. And it's giving it an extra frame whenever it goes a loop. So we're just going to select this chunk here, hit F6 to turn them to keyframes. So this timing should all be preserved there. And we're going to hit Control F. Shift F5, and that will remove that one keyframe, so everything should be nice and even now. So it has the same amount on both sides. So when it loops, it should loop nice and smoothly now. Okay, and now we can turn this into a ball and chain. So if we go inside of the symbol here, we're just going to make a couple of new layers. And these are for the spikes. Let's draw in some spikes. I'm gonna use a lighter fill color for these so they stand out some from the main part of the ball. They don't have to be perfect, just draw in whatever you end up liking for yours. And we can always make adjustments as we go. So K is the shortcut for the paint fill bucket. And I'm just going to delete all these little ends. And you can just drag around the points on these lines and until you kind of get this looking the way you like. You can color it whatever way you like. As long as the ball remains relatively in the same location, it doesn't really matter what you do for the drawing. What I just did right there was I copied that one, pasted it, and then I flipped it horizontal, and it didn't go exactly where I was expecting it to. So I just ended up rotating it. Okay, and right now it's in the way of this line right here, so we're gonna just Control A. I'm just gonna rotate that a little bit. And it's not perfect, but it's fine for this. Now I'm just gonna select this keyframe, hold down Alt, and drag this down. Lock everything else except for this one layer by holding down Alt and clicking on the lock right here. And hitting Control A to select everything that's under there. I'm just gonna rotate the sum and make it smaller, the transform tool. And we're just gonna color these a little bit of a darker color, maybe. Just so they stand out a bit from the other color I was using. There. And now we're just gonna turn this line into a chain. Making a new layer. Then I'm going to select this to turn off the fills for now. And I'm just gonna make a little circle here and make it thicker. Now I'm just gonna match it up with that line. Then select it, hold down Alt to make a copy, and leave a little bit of space in between each of these circles. And I just adjust them to make sure that they match with that line for where the oval is from each point. So you're looking good, and that looks right. I'm gonna cut that and paste it in place by hitting Ctrl-Shift-V. Delete the middle part of this line here, that's inside of the circles. And then using the eyedropper tool, we're just gonna select the information off of this and paste it along here so it matches on the same width. And then we have a chain. I noticed that these spikes are actually in the way of the chain right now. So I'm just gonna select all three of those layers and rotate it a little bit so it's not in the way. Okay, if we come back out here now, we have a ball and a chain swing. If it's not quite exactly where you want on your stage, you can just move it around a little bit. You can also make it smaller or bigger or make copies by holding down Alt. And if you wanted to offset these copies when they play back, you can just set this one to frame 21 to loop from, and the other one from frame 1. And you get something like that. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any comments, questions, or tutorial requests, please let me know in the comments. Feel free to subscribe for more tutorials, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you!